let's look at gap schemes, three-man surfaces. Okay. All right. So this look right here. So this would be a highway alignment. So now the issue becomes gap schemes and how we want to play that, right? So let's say we line up in tight. And now we get off of this look, we get buck sweep, right? We get counter OT, right? All of these are going to present the same problem. Okay, so like if we were to get something like this to this, the angles are bad off of this look, okay? Right, we're all in here, they're all over there. Okay, so the math is bad. Right, and so we want to be able to change the math here, and not live in this world. Okay, and so that's buck sweep with both guards pulling. Counter OT would be both of these guys pulling, same down blocks here. Really, kind of a different way of getting to the same issue. You know, gap scheme to a three-man surface. Okay, all right. So what we've done there is, if a team is a big zone team, right? And we got two and one over here, right? If a team's a big zone team and they're not a huge gap scheme team, we would still stay with Eagled, right? Because let's say if they're going to buck sweep, there's some that have, and we can get that, okay? All right, so there's some that have, and we can get that. I think we played some games, but that's the case. This would be the least favorite if we were getting a lot of gap schemes to a highway alignment over there off the back. Okay, the advantage with that would be you're not playing with a B gap, right? You could go shade, which is basically playing under. And now the thought is, now you're getting this, right? And so if you were to get any form of a gap scheme now, right? So let's say it's something like this, and it's counter OT, you're at least getting a double to take a little bit off and allow linebackers right here. So there's somebody forcing it, right, sending it back, and so forth.